Hillary Clinton under yet more rhetoric gunfire from fellow Democrats this morning. They're accusing the senator of driving in reverse after she released this statement. And here it is, quote, "As president, I will not support driver's licenses for undocumented people and will press for comprehensive immigration reform that deals with all of the issues around illegal immigration, including border security and fixing our broken system." Well, her rivals arguing that that doesn't square with what Clinton said at last month's Democratic debate.
It makes a lot of sense. What is the governor supposed to do? He is dealing with a serious problem. We have failed, and George Bush has failed. Do I think this is the best thing for any governor to do? No. But do I understand the sense of real desperation trying to get a handle on this? Remember, in New York, we want to know who's in New York. We want people to come out of the shadows. He's making an honest effort to do it. We should have passed immigration reform.
Already the Obama campaign is weighing in. Quote, "When it takes 2 weeks and six different positions to answer one question on immigration, it's easier to understand why the Clinton campaign would rather plant their questions than answer them." Wow. NBC political director Chuck Todd joins us now. And Chuck, I guess first of all, the latest statement from Clinton seems pretty clear on the issue. Does it sort of help Hillary Clinton at this point put this all behind her, or is the damage done here?
Well, no, I think for a short period of time, the damage is still going to be done. I mean, long term, she may have the right position for the general election. I mean, it is a vast majority of people support this idea that, you know, you don't give illegal immigrants an ID card. And so that seems to be good for the general election. But as far as short term damage, it's still there because it does look like she now, after waiting 4 weeks to answer the question, finally has a position on it. So she's vulnerable to that. But what I found fascinating last night is that the Clinton campaign decided to embrace their new position now that they have one, and then they attack John Edwards, yeah, who has yet to take a position. You know, Obama is for it. You know, Obama and Clinton now are on the opposite sides on this issue. Obama was supportive of Spitzer's plan and says he would support this idea of giving illegal immigrants driver's license. Not a very popular position. As far as the general electorate's concerned, we'll see if it even is a popular position inside the Democratic primary.
What did you think of how the Obama campaign handled this? Because they went after her and, you know, kind of 2 weeks, six different positions to answer one question on immigration. They didn't hold back.
Well, what they're trying to do is, look, I think they believe that Clinton's vulnerability is when you can emphasize the Clinton part of her name, when you can somehow talk about parsing a sentence or being calculating. And they're using this immigration as an example of trying to get at that broader message that they're trying to go after her on. So it's not necessarily on the issue, but that's what they're trying to do. We'll see. I think that the Clinton folks realize they had to take a position. Now, I think some of them would argue the reason they took so long to have a position is because it was her home state governor who was fighting this thing, and they didn't want to look like they were stepping on him or creating problems for him politically. But still, it looks bad that it took this long for her to take a stand.
All right, and just real quick on this hot button issue of health care. A deadline today for Massachusetts residents to sign up for health insurance or face possible penalties, a requirement Mitt Romney signed into law when he was governor. Fred Thompson, John McCain, Rudy Giuliani, all using the milestone to sort of attack Romney at this point. Break this down for me. Is this a potential problem for the Republican candidate?
Well, it's an attempt to try to undermine the idea that Romney's a conservative. They're trying to attack him on this, not on the issue of health care and somehow that he's, you know, was trying to sign a bill, trying to create a new law, et cetera, but instead hit him that saying, look, this thing is a tax on people. This thing penalizes folks. This isn't market. This isn't a conservative approach to solving the health care crisis. Fred Thompson sent out a fundraising email noting that this law actually makes it possible to get fairly inexpensive abortion procedures, which then, of course, allowed Thompson to tout his own pro-life credentials. So he's getting hit from all sides today on this issue. But it's not about health care. It's about trying to undermine his conservative credentials.
Chuck Todd, thank you very much.
Okay, Mika.